रेडी।
Friend Samriddhi is having some problem, so let her join within 1 minute and then we will start the meeting.
Yes.
And now we are playing ICI Moto Song. I request all the participants to put their right hand on their heart.
Yaesha supte shujagrati. Yaesha supte shujagrati. Kamam 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 kamamsho purusho nirvimanah nirvimanah tadev shukram tadev shukrad brahma tad brahma tadeva amartam.
Chairman of the branch, CA Fenil Shah, in his absentia, learned faculty Samriddhi and Padmaja Madam, coordinator of this whole series, Eid Gajjar. So it's really pleasant to know that we are approaching to new ways of doing things, and I can say the tools which we required for drafting or for appearing before any authority, how to speak, how to write, how to research. And we acknowledge the efforts put in by Samriddhi and the curator of this series. So thank you, Samriddhi. And today we are also going to learn something from her. And it's a great privilege when a student and I can say member of Vikasa joining us and giving us a knowledge how to be a master in the different fields. Also, friends, we are having tomorrow a physical seminar on GST audit, as you all are aware that GST audit's due date is approaching, that is 20th February 2021. So let's all come together and learn this opportunity, how we should complete that task. Also, we are going to have from 6th, 6th, 7th GST RRC at Rajkot. There are limited seats left, I guess, 4 to 5 seats. So please, if you have any inclination to join in physical interaction, discussion, then definitely you can register yourself on online link, or you can send the check or registration form at the branch. And also we are going to have on 5th and 6th IT conference at Hyatt Hotel. So a person who inclines to sharpen his skills in information technology, then he also can join in that conference. With these words, now I request Hit Bhai to take it forward and eager to listen Samriddhi. Thank you so much, Vishen sir.
Now I request Kairav Shah to please give an introduction about Samriddhi ma'am.
Hello, am I audible?
Yes, you are.
Yeah.
Ms. Samriddhi Mandavat ma'am is a person with unbound achievements. She holds a world record for being the youngest female author to have donated all royalties for women upliftment. She has been nominated for prestigious Padma Shri Award, which is the fourth highest civilian award of India. She served as first female CA student to take up the chair of secretary at Ahmedabad CA Students Association. Apart from this, Samriddhi ma'am is a national speaker on various topics of finance, economics, management, and tax, and has addressed N number of students. She also has authored various books like Unobliterated, Unspoken Emotions, and another book named Loved, Lost, and Lived. She is a freelance motivational speaker as well and has trained many CA students. So I would request everyone to acknowledge the presence of Ms. Samriddhi Mandavat ma'am.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Over to you, ma'am.
So, आज का टॉपिक जैसे कि था रिसर्च एंड रिव्यू. हम तीन दिन से रीडिंग, राइटिंग और स्पीकिंग पे तो बात कर ही रहे हैं. Am I audible, Heath? You just confirm.
Yes.
And
yes,
am I visible also?
Yes. Yes.
Yeah. So, हम तीन दिन से, आज हमारा थर्ड डे है इस वर्कशॉप का अबाउट रीडिंग, राइटिंग एंड स्पीकिंग. एंड दिस वर्कशॉप इज नेम्ड एज पनाश. एंड आई वुड लाइक टू थैंक अहमदाबाद ब्रांच ऑफ WIRC एंड विकासा फॉर होस्टिंग दिस यूनिक वन ऑफ अ काइंड वर्कशॉप, जहाँ पे हमने दो दिन तो बात की ही थी रीडिंग के ऊपर, राइटिंग के ऊपर, स्पीकिंग के ऊपर. वी हैव हैड विटनेस्ड लर्नड फैकल्टीज लाइक नीना सिंह जी, स्नेहल देसाई जी, कुसुम चोपड़ा जी एंड कुमार पाल जैन जी. एंड आगे रुचि शर्मा जी स्पोक ऑन डे वन. आगे हमारे साथ आज जुड़ेंगे श्री बाईजी लाल पद्मजा कुमारी राठौर, हु इज द प्रिंसेस ऑफ जोधपुर घराना. उनके बारे में आपको बताएंगे. एंड कल हमारे साथ हैं आशीष ठक्कर जी और कुमार पाल जैन जी. सो आप थर्ड डे पर भी वापस आए हो, दिस इटसेल्फ शोज हाउ मोटिवेटेड यू ऑल आर. And with this positivity and zeal, let's Hello. Take things forward. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, yaar.
Achha, that's a glitch from... Okay, that's a glitch from Milin Shah ji. So, I'll continue. हमने काफी like reading, writing और speaking के बारे में काफी हद तक तो बोल ही दिया है और बात कर ही ली है. मेरा आज का टॉपिक था रिव्यू एंड रिसर्च, जो मैंने फर्स्ट डे ही कवर अप कर लिया था. टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट विद ब्रेनस्टॉर्मिंग एंड रिसर्च, ब्रेनस्टॉर्मिंग एंड इम्प्रोव. व्हेन इट कम्स टू ब्रेनस्टॉर्मिंग, देयर आर मल्टीपल वेज वेयर यू कैन ब्रेनस्टॉर्म. नंबर वन इज हाउ टू डू सेल्फ टॉकिंग. नाउ व्हेन आई से सेल्फ टॉकिंग, तो ऐसा ही होता है कि हम अपने आप से बात करने लगते हैं. कैन आई सी सम ब्यूटिफुल फेसेस? आई कैन ओनली सी हेज. Today, basically, my laptop is not with me, but can I see beautiful faces? Yeah, Karab, thank you so much for showing your face. Thank you, Dharmesh ji. Yeah, anyone else? Whoever is joining. So yeah, brainstorming की जब हम बात करते हैं, जब हम brainstorming की बात करते हैं, तो number one पे आता है self talking. Self talking is like speaking to oneself कि आप आगे क्या करना चाहते हैं. रोज सुबह हम जब उठते हैं, भगवान को प्रे करते हैं, तो अपन अपने आप से बात नहीं करते आज ये करना है, आज वो करना है. तो जब आप कुछ लिखने बैठते हैं तो उसमें भी आप सेल्फ टॉकिंग करना शुरू करते हैं. कुछ भी हो, जैसे आपको मैं बोल दूं कि आपको एलिफेंट पे लिखना है, या फिर मैं बोल दूं एक रूम पर लिखना है, या मैं बोल दूं एजुकेशन सिस्टम पे लिखना है, तो वो एक ब्रेनस्टॉर्मिंग करते हैं सेल्फ टॉकिंग के साथ. दूसरा टेक्निक होता है कि हम सेल्फ टॉकिंग करें छोटे छोटे चिट्स बना के या छोटे छोटे पॉइंट्स बना के. अब जरूरी नहीं है कि जब राइटिंग हो तभी आपको वो चिट फॉर्म में लिखना है. जब आप कहीं पे स्टेज पे बोलने जाते हैं तो आपको क्या बोलना है उससे पहले भी आपको ब्रेनस्टॉर्मिंग करनी पड़ती है. आज जैसे मैं यहाँ पर आई हूँ तो मुझे अभी क्या क्या बोलना है, तो वो मैं अपने आप में एक लिस्ट प्रिपेयर करके आई हूँ. नाउ आई एम मोर ऑफ अ सेल्फ टॉकिंग पर्सन. तो मैं जैसे ही ये सेशन स्टार्ट होने वाला था उससे पहले मैंने अपने ही माइंड में अपने आप से बात कर ली कि हाँ आज मैं ये बात करूंगी, आज ये बात करूंगी, एंड दिस इज हाउ आई टेक थिंग्स फॉरवर्ड. सो आई हैव दैट एजेंडा. जो एजेंडा की मैं बात करूँ, दैट आई हैव दैट एजेंडा इन माई माइंड. कई बार ऐसा होता है कि हम वी आर नॉट यूज टू सेल्फ टॉकिंग, तो हम वो एजेंडा को नोट डाउन कर देते हैं. समटाइम्स इट इज ऑल्सो पॉसिबल दैट वी आर नॉट यूज टू राइटिंग, तो हम हमारे मोबाइल में टाइप कर देते हैं. Now, typing and writing are two different things. और मैं उस चीज को क्यों emphasis कर रही हूँ, because writing with a pen and typing with your fingers is altogether two different things. When you write with pen, your senses actually sense that thing and that penetrates in you. And when you're typing something, your mind tends to affect technology is very useful to us. Taking forward, self-talking or छोटे-छोटे points लिखने की बात कर ली. When I say more about brainstorming, तो हम उसके ऊपर ये क्या बोलते हैं about talking to someone who we prefer to be our mentors. अब जैसे when I say कल कितने लोगों ने स्नेहल देसाई जी का lecture attend किया था? Can you raise your hand? Wait, how many participants are there? I can actually not see anyone.
69 participants. 70.
Okay. So can everybody, if you can't raise your hands, can you please show your hands up so that, because I'm going to link something from the previous session. Yash Patel ji has attended. Fair enough. Not an issue on that. Oh, am I audible and visible now? Huh. So yeah, Yash Patel ji has attended the session. So I prefer Snehal Desai ji as my mentor. So now it's been more than 6 years now of knowing him and also working under him. So I get to know that person professionally and personally. अब क्योंकि आप किसी के साथ प्रोफेशनली और पर्सनली सिंकल होते हो तो उनके साथ बातें करना आपके लिए बहुत इजी हो जाता है. किसी और ने भी हाथ ऊंचा किया था, थैंक यू सो मच. तो या मैं वही बता रही थी. तो व्हेन यू नो समबडी मे बी पर्सनली और मे बी ऑन प्रोफेशनल फ्रंट, इट इज इजी फॉर दैट पर्सन और इट इज इजी फॉर यू टू टॉक टू दैट पर्सन. तो इस वजह से इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू हैव वन लाइफ मेंटोर इन योर लाइफ. अब लाइफ मेंटर्स कैसे सेलेक्ट करते हैं या कैसे चूज करते हैं, इट इज वेरी सिंपल. आप जिनके साथ सबसे ज्यादा कंफर्टेबल हो, जैसे कंफर्टेबल व्हेन इट कम्स टू लाइक व्हेनेवर यू आर इन प्रॉब्लम एंड यू अप्रोच अ पर्सन, दैट पर्सन गिव्स यू अ सॉल्यूशन एंड दैट सॉल्यूशन फिट्स बेस्ट इन दैट प्रॉब्लम इन विच यू आर, एंड देन यू कैन डिसाइड फॉर, विच इज वेरी नॉर्मल थिंग. नंबर टू इज टू इंटरैक्ट. नाउ वी हैव हाईली what do you say, like interaction is highly underrated. हम कितनी बार ऐसा होता है कि अरे पब्लिक में क्यों बात करें, बात करने से क्या हो जाएगा, बट वी नेवर नो कि हम सामने वाले इंसान से इंसान के बारे में क्या कुछ जानते हैं या नहीं जानते हैं. सो वन ऑफ माई फाइनेस्ट एग्जाम्पल्स दैट आई कुड शेयर इज, मैं एक बार फ्लाइट में ट्रेवल कर रही थी. आई वॉज ट्रेवलिंग फ्रॉम अहमदाबाद टू दिल्ली एंड बैक फॉर. तो मैं जब दिल्ली से अहमदाबाद वापस आ रही थी तो मेरे बगल में there was a very gentleman, a sick old man, and I was reading this book called The Age of Turbulence. I don't know that man. The man doesn't know me, but the man and me, both of us, knew that book, and that book was Age of Turbulence. Coincidentally, उन्होंने भी वो book पढ़ी थी. So he was saying, he was asking me, क्या आप कौन से चैप्टर पर हैं, क्या है. आई वॉज गिविंग द डिटेल्स एंड ही आस्क्ड मी फर्दर. तो मैं कहीं ना कहीं कतरा गई. मैंने बोला एक्सक्यूज मी सर, आई एम जस्ट रीडिंग माई बुक, कैन आई नॉट टॉक टू यू, बिकॉज आई वॉज हेजिटेंट इन इंटरैक्टिंग विद दैट पर्सन. दिस इज अ रियल लाइफ केस स्टोरी, जस्ट कंटिन्यू, आई मीन कम अप विद मी, आई मीन फॉलो मी. So I was hesitant and I was like, sir, is it okay if I don't interact and can I please read the book? So he was like, okay, not an issue, ma'am. I'm so sorry. I jaise plane take off hua, to maine thoda sickness jaisa hua, to maine book band karke aage apne seat ke aage jo jagah hoti hai wahan pe rakh di, and I was like listening to my songs, earphones laga diye the, gaane dekh rahi thi, mobile से कुछ मूवी जो डाउनलोडेड थी वो चेक कर रही थी. दैट पर्सन अगेन सेड, ओ आई वाज वाचिंग चक दे इंडिया. तो ही सेड, ओ चक दे इंडिया देख रहे हो, मैंने भी देखी थी अपनी बेटी के साथ. सो आई वाज लाइक, या वुड यू माइंड वाचिंग अलोंग विद मी आल्सो. सो दिस टाइम आई ओपनड अप बिकॉज दैट पर्सन वाज जेन्युइनली मेकिंग एफर्ट्स टू इंटरैक्ट. सो दिस टाइम आई ओपनड अप एंड देन हम दोनों ने मूवी देखना बंद कर दी साइड में, एंड वी स्टार्टेड डिस्कसिंग द बुक एज ऑफ टर्बुलेंस. एंड जैसे ही प्लेन अहमदाबाद तक लैंड हुई, आई जस्ट फॉर्मली आस्क्ड द नेम ऑफ दैट पर्सन एंड ही सेड, आई एम मुंदेक सिंह अहलूवालिया. सो ही डिडंट आस्क माय नेम एंड आई वाज टोटली फाइन विद दैट बिकॉज आई नो आई एम ऑफ नो इम्पोर्टेंस टू एनीबॉडी. But jaise hi unhone bola, I was like, oh. So he said, nice to meet you. I was like, uncle, kya main aapke number le sakti hun please? So that person said, ah, sure. Very politely, he said. He gave his number. And wo Ahmedabad mein main meri ghar aa gayi, wo jidhar jana tha wo chale gaye. After 2 months, this is where the twist happened. After 2 months, एक बुक रिलीज हुई थी और मैं क्रॉसवर्ड गई थी. मैं क्रॉसवर्ड गई थी बुक रिलीज के डिस्कशन पे, एंड दैट बुक वॉज बैक स्टेज. दैट बुक के ऑथर कौन थे? मुंदेक सिंह अहलूवालिया जी. सो यू नेवर नो. और आज का दिन है, लाइक तब का दिन था और आज का दिन है. हम आज भी कॉन्स्टेंट कॉन्टेक्ट में हैं और व्हाट्सएप पे कभी बातें करते रहते हैं. सो यू नेवर नो द पावर ऑफ इंटरेक्शन. And all my economic and political debates, jinke saath karti hu, I'm comfortable talking about, is that person. Abhi, two months back, unki wife ka bhi dehant ho gaya tha, toh I like paid my condolences also. So never ever underrate any interaction, be it whoever or under whatever circumstances, try to interact, try to speak. So मैंने तीन चीजें बताई. So of choosing role models, of course. So number one was to ऐसे जिसको आप life mentor मानते हो या जो आपके problems का solution देता है, जो generally case अपने cases में होते हैं, अपने parents या अपने teachers, उनके उनको approach करना. Number two, interact करना. और interaction जितने ज्यादा आप लोगों से interact करोगे, उतना ज्यादा आप लोगों से घुलोगे मिलोगे और उतना ज्यादा आप लोगों के बारे में जानोगे, उतना ज्यादा आप मार्केट के बारे में जानोगे. सो दिस इज हाउ यू चूज योर मेंटर्स. मैंने ब्रेनस्टॉर्मिंग की एक छोटा सा पार्ट डिस्कस किया. नाउ आई विल बी टेलिंग यू अबाउट इम्प्रोव. इम्प्रोव क्या होता है? व्हेनेवर यू आर अंडर सर्टेन सिचुएशन वेयर यू डोंट नो आगे कैसे बढ़ना है, लाइक ऐसे कितनी बार हो जाता है कि हम हमारे क्लाइंट्स के साथ बैठे हैं और एक डेड एंड आ जाता है कॉन्वर्सेशन का, और वो डेड एंड ऐसा होता है कि हमें पता नहीं चलता है कि क्लाइंट हमारा बनेगा या नहीं, या फिर वो कॉन्वर्सेशन इस तरीके से हो जाता है कि हम सोचते रहते हैं कि क्लाइंट को आगे पिच कैसे करें, और ऐसा हर जगह होता है, ट्रस्ट मी. तो when certain sort of situation that happens, जहां पे आपको लगता है बस अब आगे बातें तो हो ही नहीं पाएंगी, आगे मतलब क्या ही है, एक आ जाता है डेड एंड, मतलब बस इससे आगे ना तो कुछ पॉसिबिलिटी है इंटरेक्शन की और ना कुछ है, तब काम आता है आपका नॉलेज. और ट्रस्ट मी, लाइक मार्क मी, मैं इसे स्टैम्प पेपर पे लिखा कर दे दीजिए, अगर वो इंसान जिसके साथ आप बैठे हैं, अगर दैट पर्सन, इफ ही और शी इज जेन्युइनली इंटेलेक्चुअल पर्सन हुम यू आर अप्रोचिंग, just give a quick quote from anyone or crack an intellectual joke to that person or maybe speak to him or her about his or her background. jab aise main bolun ki chalo maan lijiye ki main abhi baat karte karte ruk gayi, ab kuch hai hi nahi mere paas bolne ko, what would I do? are hey branch pe sab theek hai, Fennel sir kaise hain?
bas ekdam badhiya.
See, it worked. Hate नहीं बोल रहा था इतने टाइम तक. He was just listening to me, but I wanted to interact so that I know उसका रिस्पॉन्स क्या है, to just know whether he's listening or not, to know whether he's attentive or not. तो ऐसे कैसे, ऐसे छोटे छोटे prompts हैं जो आप सब लोग कभी उसके background के बारे में पूछ लिया, या फिर उसके future prospects के बारे में पूछ लिया, या फिर कोई joke crack कर लिया. I know formal meetings में joke crack करना बहुत immature sound करता है, but trust me, it is an ice-breaking thing. कितनी बार ऐसा होता है when I meet publishers and when we are discussing certain royalty terms or कुछ भी, तो पैसों की बात तो एक तरफ होती है. I'm always there to crack jokes. And honestly, इसलिए मुझे बहुत ज्यादा लोग immature तरीके से देखते भी हैं कि how immature she is, but वो एक तरीका होता है जहां पे आप लोगों से और इंटरैक्ट करने लगते हैं. इम्प्रोव की बात करें आगे, तो इम्प्रोव इज वन थिंग जहां पे आप सोच सकते हैं कि अरे अभी तो हो गया ना, छोटा सा इंटरैक्शन हो गया, अब आगे क्या. इन द सेम केस, अभी मैं हेट को तो मैंने पूछ लिया फैनल सर कैसे हैं, हेट अब मुझसे कुछ पूछ नहीं रहा है तो मैं क्या पूछूंगी, या फिर मैं कैसे उससे इंटरैक्ट करूंगी. हेट, तुम्हारे सीए फाइनल के लेक्चर्स कैसे चल रहे हैं? अनम्यूट कर लो.
बहुत बढ़िया चल रहा है मैम, बहुत बढ़िया.
कहाँ से कर रहे हो, नवकार जेके शाह या प्रॉपर कोई वीडियो लेक्चर्स?
नहीं, इंस्टीट्यूट की साइट पे से ही, इंस्टीट्यूट की यूट्यूब चैनल पे से ही मैम.
ओह दैट्स अमेजिंग. तो विकासा में क्या कर रहे हो?
विकासा
अभी विकासा में कौन से पोजीशन पर हो?
नो, आई एम अ कोऑर्डिनेटर.
नो, दैट्स अमेजिंग. But coordinators are more than office bearers, to be very honest. Now, can you just see this performa? मैंने शुरू किया था सेनल सर कैसे हैं, उसके बाद लेक्चर्स के बारे में. लेक्चर्स का इसके कोऑर्डिनेशन से कोई लेना देना नहीं था, विकास से कोई लेना देना नहीं था. But this just works. अरे हेत, तुम्हें पता है
क्या?
बस पता है तुम्हें वही वाली बात.
ये हर एक के साथ होता है, लेकिन इस पे रिएक्ट कैसे करना है ये इम्पोर्टेंट है.
हाँ, तो इस पे रिएक्ट कैसे करना है, आप सामने वाले को देखो, वो किसके बारे में बात कर रहा है उसे समझने की जरूरत नहीं उसे. हाँ ये सर, अगर मैं वही सोच रहा हूँ जो आप सोच रहे हो तो हाँ मैं सही सोच रहा हूँ, और अगर मैं वो नहीं सोच रहा हूँ जो आप सोच रहे हो तो आई गेस आप मुझे बाद में बता सकते हैं. जनरली ऐसा होता है, हम फर्स्ट आते हैं किसी सिचुएशन में, तो ये चीज को आप ऐसे रिएक्ट कर सकते हैं. अब मैं आपके साथ, क्योंकि मैंने आपको ब्रेनस्टॉर्मिंग और इम्प्रोव के बारे में छोटा सा एक फॉर्मेट दिया है, हम छोटी सी एक एक्टिविटी करते हैं. हाउ कैन आई सी पीपल? ओके, देयर इज तपन भावसार एंड धर्मेश मशरू जी एंड हेत. ठीक है, हम चारों एक छोटी सी एक्टिविटी करते हैं. मैंने क्या आप लोगों से कुछ कोऑर्डिनेट किया था या कम्युनिकेट किया था पहले कि हम ये कुछ करेंगे ऐसा?
नो
तपन एंड तपन जी एंड धर्मेश जी ठीक है तो अब मैं है ना एक छोटा सा छोटी सी कोई भी लाइन बोलूंगी आपको उस लाइन को कंटिन्यू करके आगे कोई लाइन बोलनी है एंड उसमें आपको थोड़ा फन एलिमेंट ऐड करना है ओके मैं बोलूंगी एक लाइन और धर्मेश जी को फन एलिमेंट ऐड करना है आई सॉ एन एलिफेंट
Elephant is
yes, very, I saw an elephant.
Elephant is smaller than ant.
In a zoo.
Yeah. अब आपको क्या लगता है? बोलने के बाद आपको कुछ एकदम डरावनी चीज बोलनी है इसी चीज को कंटिन्यू करते हुए
Elephant is mad.
अभी तपन जी की बारी है हम तपन जी को वो चांस देते हैं
Pardon him, I couldn't get because video got stuck in between.
अच्छा मैंने एक लाइन बोली थी आई सॉ एन एलिफेंट फिर धर्मेश जी ने उसे आगे कंटिन्यू करा था कि एलिफेंट इज स्मॉलर देन एन एंट अब आपको ऐसी कोई लाइन बोलनी जिससे आगे वाली लाइन में थोड़ा डर हो या थोड़ा हॉरिफिकनेस हो
थोड़ा
थोड़ा
हॉरिफाइड
हो वो
ओके एंट वाज बिलो द ब्रिज एंड एलिफेंट वाज ऑन द ब्रिज
तो वो डरावना कैसे है अच्छा कि एलिफेंट ब्रिज पर है तो ब्रिज टूट जाएगा और एंट मर जाएगी
जो भी मतलब निकाल सकते हो
ठीक है अब हेट के पास जाते हैं हेट इसी चीज को तुम कॉमेडी में वापस एक फोर्थ लाइन बोलो जिसमें वो कॉमेडी दिखे Hello, Hate. Are you there?
Yes, I'm here.
Yeah, he is. Yes, Hate.
Ma'am, I can't get it.
So I said I saw an elephant. Dharmesh, she continued. The elephant was smaller than an ant. Or फिर तपन ने आगे कहा, the ant was under the bridge where elephant was. अब आपको कुछ फनी चीज ऐड करनी है और एक नई लाइन ऐड करनी है
द एलिफेंट इज डांसिंग
कूल तो अब क्या हुआ क्या हम लोगों को पता थी नहीं बट अब आप स्टोरी फॉर्मेशन देखिए आई सॉ एन एलिफेंट द एलिफेंट वाज स्मॉलर देन एन एंट अब ये चीज इमेजिनरी है बट हम आगे वाले को एंटरटेन कर रहे हैं I saw an elephant. The elephant was smaller than an ant. The elephant was on the bridge where ant was beside it and the elephant was dancing. अब पता चलता है ना कि ये elephant अगर bridge पे dance कर रहा है तो bridge टूट जाएगी और ant मर सकती है. But क्या इस चीज को हम आगे continue करें? अभी हमने अब एक dead end आ गया है. अब एक dead end आ गया है क्योंकि मैंने आपको पहले ही बोल दिया कि elephant is dancing तो अब bridge टूट जाएगी. तो एंट मर जाएगी इसके आगे कुछ नया सोच सकते हो आई विल गिव अ वन स्टेटमेंट अगेन आई सॉ एन एलिफेंट द एलिफेंट वाज स्मॉलर देन एन एंट द एंट वाज अंडर द ब्रिज वेयर एलिफेंट वाज एंड द एलिफेंट वाज डांसिंग एज द एलिफेंट स्टॉप डांसिंग द एंट वेंट इनटू हिज नोज अब आगे धर्मेश जी थोड़ा कॉमेडी ऐड कीजिए एक लाइन
मेरा मुझे अंग्रेजी में नहीं आएगा
हाँ कोई बात नहीं सर आप हिंदी में बोलिए कि गुजराती में का होता मैं
પછી કીડી હાથીના નાકમાં જાય છે અને હાથી છીકે છે અને તોફાન આવી જાય છે અને બધા ઉડી જાય છે
मुझे समझ में नहीं आया हेट, क्या आप मेरे लिए ये ट्रांसलेट कर सकते हो?
फिर वो क्या होता है कि वो चींटी है वो हाथी के नोज में चली जाती है, ठीक है, फिर हाथी छींकता है जोर से और बड़ा सा तूफान आ जाता है और सब लोग हवा में उड़ जाते हैं।
नाइस तपन, अब आप आगे एक और लाइन कंटिन्यू कीजिए।
तूफान में सब चींटियां भी उड़ने लगती है और डांस करने लगती है।
परफेक्ट। हे तब आप आगे बताइए, आप म्यूट है हे।
हाँ। भी बहुत फनी हो गया मैम, इससे आगे तो मैं
नहीं, कुछ भी ट्राई कीजिए, कुछ भी। सी, ये एक वर्कशॉप है जहाँ पे मुझे आप लोगों का क्रिएटिव माइंड अनलॉक करना है। तो अभी देखा, अभी हाथी डांस कर रहा था, डांस करते करते चींटी उसके नाक में चली गई, इतना जोर से उसने चीखा कि अब सारी चींटियां डांस कर रही है, ये कितना यूनिक हो गया। अब आप भी बताइए आगे, अपना क्रिएटिव माइंड को थोड़ा जो ब्लॉक है उसे अनब्लॉक कीजिए।
डांस करते करते चींटियां थक गए और उनको भी भूख लगी बहुत।
ओके, मैंने एक हाथी को देखा, वो हाथी चींटी से तो छोटा था, तो लेकिन वो उस ब्रिज पे खड़ा था जहां पे चींटी नीचे थी और हाथी ऊपर। हाथी ब्रिज पे डांस करने लगा, डांस करते करते ऐसा हुआ कि चींटी उसके नाक में चली गई। जैसे ही चींटी नाक में गई तो हाथी ने इतना जोर से छींक मारा कि बाकी सारी चींटियां भी उसके छींक से उड़ते हुए डांस करने लगी, और डांस करते करते वो भी थक गई। अब क्योंकि डांस करते करते वो थक गई तो वो और जितने भी हाथी थे उधर उनके नाक में चले गए और सारे हाथी छींकने लगे। सो सी, अभी मैंने एक स्टार्ट किया था कि एक मैंने एक हाथी को देखा
ना,
और अब स्टोरी कहाँ चली गई कि सारे हाथी डांस करने लगे हैं। अब ये जो ट्रांजिशन है, मैंने एक हाथी को देखा और सारे हाथी डांस कर रहे हैं, ये जो ट्रांजिशन है और इसके बीच में जो हमने क्रिएट किया उसे हम कहते हैं इम्प्रोव। और ये बी इट राइटिंग और बी इट स्पीकिंग, उसमें बहुत काम आता है। हम एक और छोटी सी एक्टिविटी करते हैं। कैन आई हैव सम अदर पीपल एज वेल, मे बी कैरा, कल धारा जी भी थी, धारा जी वो आज भी है, नलीन जी, मैं और किसी को देख नहीं पा रही, क्या कोई और लोग भी आ सकते हैं? अपने आप स्वयं सेवक बन सकते हैं कोई और? We can have another activity with you all. Oh, wait a second. नहीं, okay, कोई भी नहीं है। फाइन, तो मेरा आज का दूसरा एक्टिविटी था हम खेलते, बट लेट्स सी, आज पद्मजा हैज जॉइंड, इस हेट हैज पद्मजा जॉइंड?
यस मैम।
ओके पद्मजा, कैन वी सी यू प्लीज? Might be somewhere. So, हाँ, talking of brainstorming and improv, तो ये एक ऐसी activity होती है जब आप writing करते हो या जब आप speaking करते हो तो बहुत important होती है। When we talk about brainstorming and improv and how to improve ourselves into this, so number one thing is to interact. Number two is to have mentors. And number three is to read as much as possible. कल रीडिंग लिस्ट, रीडिंग का सेशन हमने किया ही था। अभी आज एक और सेशन है, हाउ टू इफेक्टिवली लिसन व्हेन समबडी एल्स इज स्पीकिंग, बाय बाईजीलाल पद्मजा कुमारी राठौर, हु इज विद अस। Good evening, Padmaja ma'am. Ma'am, you need to unmute yourself.
Okay. Good evening. Good evening, everybody.
Good evening, ma'am.
So, yeah, over to you, Hate. We will take the session further.
Joined.
Weren't you doing another activity, Samriddhi? Thank you for having me.
So, I was actually, humne brainstorming or improv pe ek choti si activity ki thi where we created a scenario jahan pe humne ek haathi ko dekha tha aur uske baad sare haathi dance karne lage the. And this is how imaginary story we created through improv. And I interacted with two or three people and had this activity done.
That's really cool.
Over to you, Hate. Over to you.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. We are welcoming you on behalf of Ahmedabad branch of WRC of ICAI and Ahmedabad branch of Vikasa, ma'am. Now, Kashish, are you there? Yes. Now, I request Kashish to give an introduction about Padmaja, ma'am. Kashish?
Yes, I'm here. Good evening, everyone. Padmaja, ma'am of Jodhpur, who is filled with compassion and courage, has left the comforts of her palace and has taken it as her duty to protect, educate, and guide the people and wildlife of her state's eastern frontier, the wild of is a Taj product after see her BA, Hotel Administration, from IHM Aurangabad. She has devoted her several years in the wilderness of Godwar belt of the Aravali ranges with the tribal folks. Her compassionate nature has made her leave the luxury of Raika Bagh Palace, Jodhpur, and live the life of a common farmer. She is doing a private research on indigenous flora and conservation of wetlands for fauna. She works on Bagheera's camps on the following areas: wetland conservation, arid and semi-arid decimated, Ayurveda, protection and revitalization of indigenous medical plants and trees, native species, livestock grazing, and the associated difficulties. With this, ma'am, it is our pleasure to welcome you on this platform, and we all are looking forward for this extremely amazing workshop. Thank you so much, ma'am.
What do you ma'am?
Sorry to interrupt. Can I add something?
Yes.
Padmaja is not only handling Bagheera's camp, she has also founded School of Self-Learning, and she is also a national level shooting champion. Abhi, she will be representing India also. And at her School of Self-Learning, she honestly, give a huge round of applause for her. Please clap for her. At her School of Self-Learning, ये ट्राइबल किड्स को एजुकेशन देती है, उनको जो नितिग्रिटीज है लाइफ के बारे में, उनके बारे में उन्हें एजुकेट करती है. एंड शी इज इन एब्सोल्यूट अग्रीमेंट ऑफ having knowledge over degrees, having wisdom over life. So, taking session forward, Padmaja, over to you. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Samriddhi. You've been really kind with your introduction to me, and I'm not representing India as yet. So, that little slight correction I would like to make, but thank you. Thank you so much for that kind, and I don't think I've done so much to deserve this great introduction, but thank you so much. And I hope I can live up to at least a little bit of it. So, aaj ka session bahut unique hai, and without wasting too much time, we'll come to the point. So basically we are talking about listening. So all of us know we can all hear, right? We've got ears by the grace, you know, of parents who have given us birth, and we are fortunate that we can hear, right? So now I need to have everyone kind of interacting with me, because I can only see, wait, let me just, there are a lot of people who are not kind of on, so okay, fine. So I've got a few people, so I'm going to talk to you guys, okay, whoever wants to kind of open their screens out. So the first and most important thing is that I'm not going to show you any PPT or presentation because this is about listening. So I'll make certain things very clear to you to begin with, that what is listening and how important it is to listen and what's the real difference between hearing and listening. So can I have, if people can interact with me on chat, probably you can give me a thumbs up or a raise hand or something if you guys understand that we can hear and listening is an optional thing. Do we understand that basic fundamental? Or you can have your heads.
All are requested to please turn on your videos and unmute yourself.
Okay. So great. If people can raise, do a thumbs up in the chat, that's also good. In case you guys don't have too much internet to support a video, I'm absolutely fine with that. But do interact with me in the chat because it's important for me to know how many people are actually listening. Like I said, how many people are actually listening versus how many people are hearing and how many people are seeing, right? So I'll introduce to you what I really do in the School of Self-Study and what is School of Self-Study. So like the name suggests, School of Self-Study. Self-study in Hindi would be Swadhyaya, right? In Sanskrit, it would be Swadhyaya. And that, kindly enable my video. Somebody is asking to enable their video. Maybe you have to enable it yourself. There's an option on the left down below somewhere. So the School of Self-Study is, all of us are students of School of Self-Study. Each and every being out there, from a cow on the road to a domestic help, everyone who is living is in a process of self-learning in some way or the other. Be it a small bird who is learning how to eat from its mother, or somebody who's trying to create an art piece, it's all about how you channel your inner voice. Now, inner voice for some people naturally can be heard. For some people, it's a skill. Most of the time, it's a skill that we need to practice and develop. So in School of Self-Study, what we do is we work with tribals without taking them out of their comfort zone. We go to them. If there is somebody, for example, who is dyslexic or who is an outcast or who has been treated badly and been told that you're uneducated, illiterate, we look at their skill sets and their strengths. So for example, there was this one girl, her name is Indra. She was outcasted from her society because, from her own society, not just the caste, but from her society, because she was really, really dark and she could not pronounce words properly and she was slightly dyslexic. So she used to live with the animals. And because she used to live with animals, she developed an understanding and a language with the animals itself. So when she used to talk to human beings, most of them were distorted words that she would not pronounce properly. When she was working with us, she was working on a labor construction site. One day she came to me saying that she wants to work with me and she wants to do what I do. I saw her strengths, and what I realized was because she understands the language of animals, it was easy for me to make her into more of an observer because she already did that. It was a skill that she had. And from that, she learned a language which was based out of her understanding, and she became like a semi-naturalist, you call, and she actually tried to understand the name of the birds in English. Now, how is that possible? How can a person who has not been to school understand what a crow is, for example, or even the migratory species of bird, if you have to say, a bar-headed geese or a damsel crane? How can a girl from a tribal community who's been outcasted and completely crushed say the word damsel crane? So the thing is, I told her to close her eyes, and this is an activity which all of us can also do here. So I told her to close her eyes, and I told her to hear what I am saying. And I said, say the word damsel crane. So she said the word damsel crane. And then I told her to open her eyes and say the same word. She was unable to say the word with her eyes open. This is a live example I'm giving you. I told her to close her eyes again. And I repeated the word really fast. So she could not say the word really fast, but she took a sound out. And that sounded like, if you guys close your eyes, it'll sound like the word. And she actually said the word damsel crane, because I told her to say damsel crane. Now, damsel crane is actually not damsel crane. If you can understand the difference between just hearing and listening, what listening does to you is it enables you to actually understand the essence of what lies in what the person is trying to say. Like, for example, right now, I am just not talking to you with my words. I'm also talking to you with my hand gestures and my expressions. All of this comes under listening. That is, if we have the ability to see. But what if we don't have the ability to see? How do we still listen? And how do we enhance these skills? So this is how I work with tribal people. Each person is first seen for their weakness, and then I work on their weakness to get around to actually churn out strength from their weakness, which is quite a challenge. But it's easier to do it with tribal people than to do it with educated people, because educated people use their mind and their brain a lot. Everything that they will want to have a counter to everything, which is a good thing. But the point is that can stop you from listening and just kind of get you into the selective mode of selective listening, or getting distracted, or have like a criticism point of view, not a positive criticism, but actually going like, oh, so why is this person wearing a color I don't like? Or why is this person talking in an accent I'm not okay with? So a lot of personal judgment comes, which is natural, because that's what makes us, we are human beings. So that's going to obviously play a huge role. But identifying that is a huge part in achieving what we now want to achieve. So if I can have a thumbs up or a thumbs down, either of the two, for what I just said, if that's been understood by everybody, because then I'm going to set my pace accordingly. Okay, can the people in the chat give me some feedback? Okay, so I'm going to take, thank you. So I'm going to take that as a very positive thing and move forward. Now, what are we doing in this? I'm not here to give you a lecture, because I am no expert. The only thing I've done in life is simply observed nature for where it is. I'll take you back to when I was in school. I was a highly intelligent and a very bright student, but I did not like to study at all. And that's a fact. I used to look out of the window, and that used to be written in my report card every year from the time I was probably 5-7 years old. That she has a habit of looking outside the window. But what the teacher could not understand was that when I used to look at the teacher, I used to get distracted with the teacher. But when I used to look outside the window, which I'm going to kind of do, if I look outside the window, I can hear the teacher. So when the teacher never used to understand what I was trying to do, I used to lose interest in the teacher. And that's when my nature of the critical analysis of the teacher, that this teacher is a person who does not understand me, because she's just, well, as a child, you can underestimate teachers, so you call them stupid, with due respect to those teachers. So because the teacher could not understand my level of wanting to understand what she was saying, I was not looking out of the window. I was actually listening to the teacher. So these are small things that we can pay attention to. So first and foremost, every human being is different, guys. Every person and every practice is different. There are some people who can sit down and write. There are some people who can memorize. There are some people who learn pictorially. There are some people who learn verbally. So everything is paced out. Now, what suits you? That question is for you. I can give you certain fundamentals, which have been the foundation for me as a bird watcher. Now, where does my skill of observation come from? And where does my skill of listening come from? How do I all of a sudden become an expert in front of an audience that is way much more qualified than I am, to tell you what to do and why to? Everyone knows how to listen, right? So coming back to the point, bird watching is a skill. It's a skill that requires practice. Just because you have been a bird watcher for 5 years of your life, and if you don't practice for 1 year, your pace will go down. And the same thing goes for a mathematical calculation. There are some people who can calculate on their fingertips. There are some people who can calculate mentally. But if you don't do it if you don't keep practicing, so the word I'm using out here regularly is the word practice. So the first and most important thing is, if you cannot take out a disciplined time in the day, take that time out in the shower. When you are having a bath, be it brushing your teeth, close your eyes and concentrate on the sound that you allow yourself to listen. It's important for you to allow yourself to develop the skill of listening, because listening is actually a skill. Now, there are a few challenges that listening... Okay, somebody has said, even animals see into our eyes to gain confidence. Yes, that's their way of communicating. And thank you for that input. So coming back to the difficulties we might face as listeners, the first difficulty is it's human nature to get distracted. So for example, somebody is talking and somebody is, let's say, chewing a chewing gum behind you, or that can get distracting. So how do you get distracted with that? Some people have the ability to completely cut the noise out and only concentrate on what there is that is getting offered to them. That's one kind of distraction. And that happens to hypersensitive people. A person sometimes in the day can be very hypersensitive. Sometimes a voice of a pen dropping can really irritate you, and you may be like, can you not be so clumsy? Like something so basic can irritate somebody. Now, this is because you are distracted. But the fact that you can hear that pen drop, guys, please listen to this very carefully. Hear, the ability to hear is natural. The pen drop, you are listening to the pen drop. You're getting distracted with that sound. It means you have that ability of the single point concentration that can distract you, which if you churn into a skill and practice it, can actually make you accept what the next person is saying and not become a selective listener. Now, let's say somebody has a lot of issues in life, like, you know, you've had a fight at home, or let's say there is some number issues in your head, or, you know, the gatekeeper did not do salam to you properly or something, right? And that gets stuck in your head. Now you come into your area of work and you're working, and all of a sudden you get distracted and your basic work that you're doing starts getting bifurcated into thoughts. What you are doing is at that moment, without realizing, you are listening to your thoughts. So if you can ask yourself, this question is not for me, for you to answer publicly, or that question is not for somebody to kind of talk to each other with. The point is, ask yourself that question. Do I have the ability to get distracted? And is it voluntary or involuntary? Because if your mind says that it is involuntary, means that at any given time, your mind will distract you. That means you have no levels of concentration. But is that really the truth, or do you allow yourself to get distracted? So that's one. We have a counter to this. How do you not let yourself get distracted? So first and foremost, when you know you're getting highly distracted, take a break. If there is nothing that's helping you at that moment, take a break. Now, in the wild, how do I refrain from getting distracted? And I'm going to give you an example. This example comes with a caution. So somebody with a very sensitive heart, please embrace yourself. So this is... If I'm looking for a bird and I happen to get poked by a thorn, let's say on my shoulder, right? And I happen to also hear a hiss of a snake from somewhere under a rock. And I know that, oh, I need to take the photograph of that bird, or I need to take my footnote observations, or I need to hear the sound of that bird. and I can hear 2-3 other sounds, plus I'm getting poked by a thorn or the area around me is not comfortable, I allow myself to process that information. Our human brains have the capacity to process more information subconsciously, and we know this as a fact, than consciously. But if you tap into the power of allowing yourself to subconsciously tap into information, you can actually process a lot and eliminate a lot in the process. And that's exactly what we do when we listen and hear. So one technique, counter technique to distraction, is to process the distraction that you're getting distracted with while you are listening. So now in the past 10 minutes, I've spoken, and honestly speaking, ask yourselves, how many times have you been in and out of this conversation? There are some people who are nodding, which I can see, out of which I can guarantee you there are few lines that you completely spaced out with, because that is human nature. There are some people I can't see, so I presume that they are listening. But if somebody can have the courage and say in the comment box, how many times did a person actually space out? Because this is a distraction number. This is the type of distraction number two that we will learn how to counter in another practice I'll tell you, which you can do sitting at home. Great. I'm so happy that one comment says many times. So again, I'm going to reiterate myself. Listening is a skill we develop. And to develop this skill, we need to practice it. If we close our eyes every day for 10 minutes, and when I say close your eyes, I do not mean close your eyes and sit like this. No, you got to, I think the best way is going to be to blindfold yourself. If you blindfold yourself, there's a lot of information that's going to go into your ears, not through your eyes, but through your ears, which will enable you to tell you how many times you actually zone in and zone out, because it might be slightly uncomfortable, but till you don't put yourself into the uncomfortable spot, you will not be able to tap into the self-sabotaged brain that the human being is gifted with. And that's where we are complete experts. Does everyone follow what I've just said?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, great. So I'm going to give you a few pointers I have listed out here. How to be a better listener. So first, you got to be patient. That's what the wild has taught me. You got to be patient. Patience, again, involves certain... So now, half an hour is really, really little to get into details, but I'll just give you a gist of it. So I hope like you guys can, because there's so much information on the internet out there that you can actually go online and learn more about listening skills. But what I'm going to tell you is everything that I've learned from the wild, right? One is patience. To develop patience, you've got to keep yourself in a slightly discomforting zone, which puts you out from your comfort zone, because that's where you will meet yourself as a challenge and a challenger. You will see the truth and the lie, and you will be able to hear different voices in your mind that are trying to convince you in different ways, right? Which all of us go through. So for this, I can, I'll give you an example. You can answer yes or no. How many of you have actually, when you're sleeping or doing any other activity, how many times has your something inside of your brain or mind telling you that, okay, now is the time to get up? This is without the alarm. Like, now is the time to get up. Or why don't you, a thought comes into your head saying, why don't you get up and drink some water? Another thought that might come to your head is like, you're feeling lazy right now. Why don't you actually stretch? But the thing is that you don't do any of it. If your body tells you, I want water, you are too busy working, so you don't drink water. If your body is telling you, you are lazy, let's exercise or stretch, you will rather go start eating, or probably if somebody has got a vice or an addiction, they'll probably do that instead. So if you allow yourself, you are listening, you're hearing yourself, you're not listening to yourself. That difference between hearing and listening, I'm trying to not give you a definition, but I'm trying to give you these examples, because any workshop or any lecture is only complete till if the person understands the fundamental topic we are talking about. Then the stage two comes. So the first thing is practically understanding the difference between hearing and listening, right? So coming to the second most important point, how to improve your listening, how to work on your listening skills to further develop your reading skills, is that you have to at times read and listen. Listen and read, and then just listen. And see the number of times you're zoning in and zoning out. The point is you have to keep a record of the number of times you're zoning in and zoning out. Now, the third thing is, do you set yourself a goal? And if you do set yourself a goal, okay, fine, I'm going to listen to this. My goal is to listen to this. How much percent? 50%? 70%? 90%? Or 100%. What is your goal in your head when you go out that, okay, I'm going to listen to this person, or I'm going to listen to this webinar, I'm going to listen to this audio? Can I have like people typing in the chat to let me know, so I get a basic idea, so I can tell you exactly as a sports person, how do we approach this? Because now I'm going to come into exactly... All right, that's great. So yes, 100% is the answer. Now, as a shotgun shooter, we have to press the trigger in within 0 to 0.4 seconds. I'm going to reiterate myself, from 0 to 0.4 seconds, not 4 seconds, 0.4 seconds. In that, we have to make sure there is this machine that's about 20 feet away from our audible here, and there is a range that a lot of people are shooting, so there's bam bang bang going on. In this, there is a small little machine that when you call for the bird, like there is this so what we have to do is we have to call for the bird saying bird or take out a noise on a mic. So when the mic hears the noise, within 0 to 0.4 seconds, the bird comes out. And in that short period, we have to know where the bird is and we have to shoot the bird at the same time. How do we achieve that? We have earmuffs on too. We can't hear sound, but we practice blindfold listening to counter distraction. So we place ourselves in a distraction position where there are people laughing, cracking personal offensive jokes. And they can be really offensive jokes, because when you're sitting in the audience, you can say anything to the person. The person cannot get distracted. And you have got a lot of weapons going on. Plus you've got the scoreboard that's telling you who's coming first, second, third. So that's added pressure, right? And you have some other athlete in front of you trying to kind of, you know, size you up, or trying to give you a, like, you know, give you a nudge or a challenge. Between all of this, when we stand on that board, there is a machine that takes out a noise very, very slightly. That is a loading noise for the bird. It goes like khada, khada. When we hear that noise, and point to be noted is, if we are able to listen to that noise within 0.4 seconds, we need to be able to mount our weapon. Now, that bird can come out of that in a span of 0 to 3 seconds. Means when we know that we have to be ready for a 0.4 second action, and the bird, and that action can come out between 0 to 3 seconds. 3 seconds is a huge space time. Now, if you slow down time mentally, you will realize 3 seconds can seem like 3 minutes. To hold your concentration for 3 seconds, to take the right action, The only way to train yourself in that situation is to give 700% of yourself. Means you give 100% of yourself seven times over in that short period of time. Now, from a creative point of view, if I have to address this, it's going to be more like all of a sudden I get a rhyming in my mind and I, or if it comes to me, like somebody, you can probably relate to that. If there is a rhyming or a screenplay or a script that comes to you, or probably a strategy to achieve a particular a statistic or something comes to you, or you write it down or you memorize it, you do something to hold that attention, right? But it comes to you. That can be practiced via listening to the mind. Now there's not just one mind. Now this is like a really intense topic because there are so many types of minds. There is a mind that is a very clear mind. You know, in the face of catastrophe, in the face of crisis, it is calm, composed, and it knows how to take action. And that action most of the times is a good action. Then there is a mind that gets flustered. There is a mind that gets unhappy. There is a mind that wants. There is a mind that needs. There is a mind that is jealous. There is a mind that is angry. There is a mind. So there are so many different type of minds. Between all of these minds is a very, very calm and composed self that has the ability to hold concentration. Consider it like a muscle in your head. Like, if you realize that you have the ability to hear, then you know that you have the ability to concentrate to what the next person's saying. Now, there are three types of concentrations. One is, and all three are pseudo concentrations. One kind of concentration would be a person who is faking to concentrate, which in that there are two categories. One person who you can figure out that the person's faking. The other category is that you can't figure out what the person's faking, a concentration or not. But if there is no counter question, like now I'm going to ask a question, and that question is going to be, how many people have actually listened to what I'm saying? And that you can only prove to me if you ask me a question related to the things I've said. If a person's not being able to do that, that means the person has not entirely heard what you, the person has heard what you've said, but the person has not listened to all what you've said. So there is this really thin line between differentiating between hearing and listening, and how to further practice those techniques. For me, I just do very basic, simple things. I spend some time in the around trees and plants, and I hear willingly. I try to listen to the different type of leaves. So if you see bigger leaves coming together will create a different type of sound to when smaller leaves rustle together will create a different type of sound. The other thing I concentrate on is horns. So when I'm traveling in Delhi, because there's so much traffic, I actually start concentrating on different type of horns people are giving to other people. There are some people who will give a single beep. There are some people who will give double beeps. There are some people who will just press the beep. Now, these different sounds of horns are for me personally very irritating. But the reason I concentrate on them is because only if I allow myself to listen to the reality of events is when I'll be able to actually distinctly understand the real scenario. Is there an emergency? There are some people who have an emergency horn and is a typical emergency. When you hear a siren, you know that there is an ambulance coming, you fall out of line. But if you've noticed, there are some people who are hearing the siren behind them, but they're not listening. So they don't fall out of line. Right? So now ask me a question. Ask me a question on what I have said in the past 20 minutes.
I have one.
Okay.
Can you differentiate between walking and running of two different animals? Like the way you said about leaves, ke bade patto ki awaaz alag hoti hai, chote patto ki alag hoti hai. So जहाँ the camp where you have Bagheera's camp में जहाँ आप सफारी लेकर जाते हो लोगों को तो you also look around the animals. Can you differentiate between walking and running of different animals?
Yeah, isn't that like yes, I can. Like it, I'm sorry, I don't understand your question. So one thing about listening. Now this is great. So this is a live example. So Samithi's asked me a question and I have not understood the question. Means I'm listening to her. So I am not ashamed or embarrassed of asking her to repeat herself again because I really want to understand what she's saying. So Samithi, I'm going to ask you again. Can you please tell me what you actually mean by that question? Difference between running and
walking of animals. So it's like आप जब देखते हैं तो कोई एनिमल भाग के आपके पास आ रहा है यू मेक योरसेल्फ मोर अलर्ट और आप सुन रहे हैं नहीं दैट वॉक दैट एनिमल इज वॉकिंग एट अ स्लोअर पेस देन यू जस्ट लाइक हैव योर इमरजेंसी रेस्क्यू फ्रॉम दैट स्पॉट सो हाउ डू यू डिफरेंशिएट दैट लाइक इज दिस ऑल्सो अ लिसनिंग टेक्निक दैट वी ऑल्सो प्लान आवरसेल्फ्स विद द रेस्क्यू स्टेप्स और द रेस्क्यू टेक्निक्स एंड वी अलर्ट आवरसेल्फ्स.
Okay, so I get the gist of your question, but I don't know in what context it is. But yes, if an animal is coming, if an animal is running, for example, let's say a horse, right, or a cow. If they are running, then you can hear the hooves, so you know that they are running. But if they are walking, because the gait is slower, you can understand that they are just walking. So it's entirely depending, but I seriously don't understand, like what's the, I'm not being able to fathom the correlation. Is it about, is it that you're trying to tell me that hearing has something to do with alertness? Yes, it does.
The same thing. You got my question.
Yes, it does. It does. You got to be very alert when you hear. Now, not necessarily, alertness would not be, alertness has different subjective meanings to it. Like, for example, when we are practicing as a team, we are told to stay alert. There are times we feel we are very alert because we are energetic and we are ready to, like, you know, take the challenge on this, that, and the other. But we are missing the point. Every time that we call for the shot, we miss the point. We are missing the point because we are not alert, but we think we are alert. So again, tapping within and questioning there is a mind that is a self-sabotage mind that tells you that you are present in the moment, but you are actually wandering off mentally somewhere on a holiday. And then you come back. There are some people who can bring themselves back. Like, I don't know if everyone's comfortable with meditation because there are certain skills that get enhanced with breathing techniques. Now, everyone's not interested in breathing again. So I'm just positioning it down to for you to understand whether you listen to yourself or not. Once you do that is when you'll be able to take this particular practice further because there is so much information online. It's unbelievable. But what the wild has taught me is that you got to have your wits about, you got to be able to practice patience, and you got to be able to hear what your mind is telling you for you to be able to actually further do whatever it is you want to do. If it's reading a book, like for me, I used to be a very, very slow reader, And if somebody would read to me, I would pay more attention and that's how I used to study. I used to make somebody else read for me. Now, like I started off earlier saying that everyone's got different levels of understanding of a particular subject. So I cannot be general. I cannot just generally say, you do this, you do this, you do this, you do this, and this is how you're going to achieve it. It doesn't work like that. And it doesn't work like that is because the kind of people I work with, I've noticed that for me to make them understand certain things or make them into naturalists or bird watchers, we have to first understand their
shortcomings and then work on their shortcomings to actually enhance the ability for them to perform. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
So if you can identify your shortcomings and then you don't look at them as shortcomings, but you actually look at them as gateways that you can further channel to utilize for the work you do. For example, let's say you ask somebody to say something, and when that person says, let's say that person let's say the person, you ask somebody to repeat few numbers, okay, and then you listen to those numbers and you try to write those numbers again or speak those numbers again exactly the way the person spoke those numbers. That's one way of practicing. The other way of actually, because listening has, like I said, I mean, it's a skill that a person has to develop on the basis of understanding what the capability of the person is in terms of distractions. How many times does a person get distracted? If you know the number of times you get distracted, let's say, count yourself. In 1 minute, how many times do I get distracted? When you know that, okay, I get distracted 7 times in a minute, let's say, or 15 times a minute, you question yourself, why is it that you're getting distracted? I'm getting distracted because of a personal situation or because of an external situation. If you can start jotting down these points and then start to practice A, patience, so put yourself into a spot that is uncomfortable and probably maybe slightly vulnerable, and then try to do a particular job that you would do otherwise. Second, put yourself in a position, like blindfold yourself or something, and allow yourself to listen. When your body is telling you to go drink water, how many times do you actually drink that water? Ask yourself that question. How much time do you give your personal self and listen to what you are saying to yourself? Once you have done that bit is when further you will be able to use other techniques to further develop this skill. That's what I'm trying to get at. Am I making sense to you guys?
Yes,
absolutely.
Absolutely, ma'am. Completely understandable.
Does anyone have a question that they would like to... Any questions I can answer? Because see, I don't want to say things like, do pranayama. You know to do pranayama. I cannot tell you that, okay, this is the technique to do the pranayama, because there are enough techniques out there from masters who are qualified to tell you, like from Hatha yoga teachers to, you know, I mean, anyone who is certified to teach you that, you know, there are books that can teach you that. I'm nobody to tell you to go meditate, because there's some people who don't like to meditate. They rather write a journal, you know, they rather say, okay, my way of meditation is playing golf, or my way of meditation is cooking food, you know. So it's not about sitting in one place and, but what I can tell you is, whatever you are doing, like you suggested, alertness is one thing, but whatever you're doing, try to see one step from the other and try to see the space between the two steps. And how many times can you actually hold your concentration? It's like, jab aap tadka dalte ho, you know, khane mein, jeera dalte ho. So you can hear the crackling of the jeera. Then you can see the color change. Then you can see, you can smell the jeera, and you know exactly when to put in the next masala, right? That's because you are listening. Cooking is a process. Now, if people, all those people who know how to cook or enjoy cooking, you guys understand what I'm trying to say, the difference between just hearing and listening.
Yes,
ma'am. If there's any question anyone has, please ask me, because then I can take this further.
How many of you are hearing me and not and not listening?
He's nodding sir.
Ma'am, I have one small thing which I have noticed.
Yes, sir.
That when I am working at my office place, I am able to control completely. I am with me. The moment I reach home, my children are complaining to me that, Papa, you are not listening to me fully. So they are able to immediately judge me from my eyes or from my behavior or whatever, that, Papa, you are not there with me. So one thing I have noticed, when I am at my work, I'm able to concentrate completely. I'm regularly meditating and in a sense, I would say that I'm meditating for years. And so it really helped me a lot in enhancing my ability, different abilities, which I've really noticed and practiced and enjoying really. So when I'm listening to family members or when I'm listening to my my friends or somewhere, my mind sometimes goes into some other thoughts. So at that time, I believe that is it my intention? Is it my habit? Or I need to practice something to improve? So can you guide me how to go about it?
So that's a wonderful, wonderful question. And thank you for being so honest. And I would like to let you know that you have given yourself the answer. You have guided your own self. You have said things like, I'll repeat what you've said. You've said things like, I pay attention at work, but when I go home and my children talk to me, I do not listen. I do not listen to them because they tell me that, Papa, you're not listening to us. Then you've said that, so that's one thing that you already know that you're doing.
And yes. I know.
And that can have many reasons, sir. That can have the first and foremost reason, which I have noticed, is that it's because when you come home, you just want to not hear anything. You don't want to hear anyone's problems. You don't want to hear any complaint. You don't want to hear, even if someone gives you a compliment or someone says how much they love you, you acknowledge it, but you don't think you don't think that you're entitled to say it back, because you somewhere think that obviously, you know, you mean I'm doing all of this for you guys only. So this is the pressure I think the society is in. So please don't beat yourself too much over it. The second thing I would like to bring to your notice is that you said yourself is that, am I doing it intentionally that I'm going off somewhere? Or is it a habit?
Mm.
So it's an intentional habit.
Yes.
You're not doing it intentionally. You don't want to. You want to be with your friends, but you don't want to be with them because the habit of listening, all of that, paying attention, work, you are channeling all of that emotion of yours in work. So when you are actually out there in your emotional space, listening becomes, because listening has become a work-related scenario. So when it comes to emotionally, I would suggest that you try to listen to your own self. If you take a break, and if thoughts like work, money, stress about an employee or employee behavior or meeting targets and demands, if these are the kind of thoughts that come to your head when you're alone, or if you're sleeping at night and all of a sudden you wake up like in your sleep, you're sleeping and you know, you don't even open your eyes, but you know you're awake because you're busy figuring something out and all of a sudden your body can feel stress. Listen to all of that. But the point is, sir, somewhere or the other, you are the one who has to break out of that habit. And it's difficult. But if you start observing every time, if you know that, मेरे को ये आदत तोड़नी है, you know, I want to break this habit. So don't take out 5 minutes. Take out 1 minute every 1 hour. 1 minute, set your time and do nothing. 1 minute mein nobody is going to get injured, right? There is no emergency, right? So try to give yourself 1 minute every 1 hour where if a thought of work comes into your head, you know, tell that thought in your head, I will address you after 1 minute. And maybe in that 1 minute, you can type a message to your family member saying, I'm thinking of you, busy, we'll get in touch later. Don't disturb me. Just talk back, but take 1 minute out. If you can do that, slowly you'll be able to break out of this pattern. It'll take time, but that 1 minute can cause you so much healing within that maybe that pattern, maybe you start listening when you go back home.
So does it mean mindfulness you are talking about? That we practice, so keeping away from all the work and just sit with yourself. Is it what you are trying to tell, or I want to do something different than my work? That is what you are trying to tell?
So mindfulness is a completely different, so it's a part of what I'm saying, and it's too big for me to address that. What I'm saying is that when I think about, when this happens to me, I can only talk from personal experience. When something like this happens to me, when I think that, you know, when my family members are talking to me and I start zoning out, I used to zone out a lot because I used to constantly be thinking of the number of trees that people are cutting to build roads. I mean, that was my concern. I'm sorry.
I have few amazing experiences, which I would not like to share here in this audience. But sometime I will certainly take a number from Samriddhi and tell you. Those are different experiences. It's not good to discuss here at this forum. I'll discuss. I have few more things which has really given me, meditation has given me, and that's really a power. Like we need food, so our soul needs meditation, or our soul also needs this. This is what in one line I would say.
Yes, I agree. But what I'm trying to say is it's not mindfulness at all. Taking out this 1 minute is a conscientious effort. See, your work cannot control you. You think you're controlling your work.
Control your work.
So that 1 minute, every hour, that 1 minute, you tell yourself, na main is kaam ka hoon, na ye kaam mera hai. Main us ek minute mein apni dil ki dhadkan sunna chahta hoon. Bas.
Present moment.
That is it. Like, present moment again is too big a word. I will not go into any of these things. I'm just saying, take out that one thing. You know, के एक मिनट के लिए मैं पूरी जो मेरा काम है, जो मेरे को कंट्रोल कर रहा है, जो मेरे को ये ईगो बूस्ट दे रहा है या जिसके लिए मैं काम कर रहा हूँ, ये सब सीज हो जाता है. कोई आपके खटखट भी करता है ना, आप ये मत बोलो कि अभी मैं बिजी हूं, या कोई खटखट करके आपको आ रहा है वहां पे, दैट यू डोंट नीड टू एक्नॉलेज दैट पर्सन फॉर दैट 1 मिनट. Just stay with your personal self for that 1 minute, because your emotion needs you. Like your employees need you. Your emotion needs you, sir. And this is not meditation. It's just spending that 1 minute with that amazing you that so many people want to spend time with. That's it.
Yes, great. Thank you.
Thank you. Anybody else that would like to say something? Okay. So, Samidhi, would you like to say something? Because you're the person who writes these amazing books, so there is a lot of reading there that I have to do, and there's a lot of listening that probably you have to do to write all of that. So can you share an experience how you manage to write connect the two thoughts that when you get into your head and make it into like a weave, because that is directly a part of listening and delivering.
Yeah, honestly, thank you so much, Padmaja. First of all, I would like to thank you for this amazing thing that you just shared right now of taking out 1 minute every day from every hour rather, and think about yourself and just interact with oneself. So ye cheez mein follow karna chahungi. And yeah, going back to the question, what things I follow when I write is that I do a lot of self-talking. I hear my words back. So I'm of a person who is like almost self-consumed by oneself. I'm most of all the days I'm talking to myself. So I have two numbers. So I interact with my own self. Ek mobile se dusre mobile se khud se baatein karte rehna, chat karte rehna. So I do self-talking a lot. So be it with texting or be it verbally, I self-talk a lot. Or dusra, I interact with people like you. So you, and there's also Snehal sir, who was a speaker yesterday. Then there's Mr. Murli Menon, we both are acquainted too. He has lovely stories to share. So Murli Menon is one person I interact on daily basis. Then there is my school principal, Mrs. Gopa Ghosh ma'am. So there I have like defined certain people in my life jinke saath mujhe roz baat karni hai. Then I have every day, matlab raat ke samay, we sit with our parents, jo aaj ke samay mein bahut kam hota hai. We regularly sit with our parents and we interact. आपका दिन कैसा था, उनसे बातें करते हैं, उनके बारे में पूछते हैं. सो दैट देयर इज दिस म्यूचुअल गिव एंड टेक रिलेशनशिप एंड ऑल दीज इमोशंस देन आई एब्जॉर्ब एंड ऑल दीज सेल्फ टॉकिंग एंड थिंग्स हेल्प मी राइट द बुक्स दैट आई हैव रिटन. यस. एंड देन आई सी वुमेन लाइक सो मेनी सो ऑनेस्टली लाइक एवरीवन हियर लाइक देयर आर लाइक अराउंड 81 participants with us. So 81 participants with us. Padmaja is one person whom I actually see up to as a role model, because living your place, living the blue blood that you've got and be into the wild really takes courage. And that path is not taken, like nobody thinks of taking that path, because कम्फर्ट सबको अच्छा लगता है, बट दैट डिसकम्फर्ट, द वल्नरेबिलिटीज दैट शी हैज एक्सपीरियंस, इट्स हरसेल्फ हैज अ लॉट ऑफ स्टोरीज टू शेयर. लाइक टेक सम टाइम ऑफ लाइक टेक सम 2-3 डेज फ्रॉम योर बिजी स्केड्यूल एंड मेक अ विजिट एट अ प्लेस, विच आई माइट बी डूइंग वेरी शॉर्टली. सो मेक अ विजिट एट अ प्लेस एंड इंटरैक्ट विथ हर, शी हैज अमेजिंग स्टोरीज टू शेयर. एंड ऑनेस्टली ट्रस्ट मी, लाइक इवन इफ शी इज लाइक whatever it is, like take some time and go to her place and visit her once.
That's really kind of you, Samidhi. You've been very, very kind with you and very generous with your words. But yes, I take this opportunity to invite our audience. There are lots of people who have taken out their precious time and are listening to me talk. And we do certain wellness and internal healing camps also. And that also has a lot of adventure attached to it. So if you want to further take, you know, the workshop for listening to the self, you can always kind of sign up with me on email or Instagram or, you know, any of these places. So that will directly benefit your work, because what I have understood is that if a dyslexic person can handle mathematical calculations, which is literally, I mean, all hard work of that person. But if that can happen, then I think the techniques that the wild has taught me, if those are used for entrepreneurs or researchers or anyone out there, you know, even housewives, if those techniques are used there, I think they can definitely enhance their
internal capability so much more.
Ma'am, that is one question. Any good book can you suggest it on this topic?
So, like I said earlier, I do not read books. My knowledge comes from practical observation of the worldly things around. But there is a book that what's the name of the book? Do you think that I can send the details to you, Ahit, and you can give it further to who's asked this question? Tapanji, right? Yes, I can. So there is a book, I'm forgetting the name of the author, but it is one book on the mind. There is one book that deals with emotional intelligence. That is something that needs to be addressed. And there is one book on mindfulness. So that I can suggest you those books. I just don't know the name of the authors and I don't want to miss author somebody. That's something I won't do. But I'll send this across to you and you can further send it to Tapanji, right?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
And I don't read. That's the thing. But I'm going to be writing a book really soon. So guys, please do read my book.
Sure. Yeah, over to you, Heath, now.
Yes, ma'am. Kashish, are you there? Yes. I request Kashish Advani, please give a vote of thanks to ma'am.
I would really like to start with this quote that actually it fits in this session especially. Most of us generally don't listen to understand, but we usually listen to reply. With this, I, Kashish Advani, on behalf of Ahmedabad branch of ICI and Vikasa Ahmedabad, would like to thank Padmaja ma'am for such an amazing session. The key takeaways that we all could actually take from this session that I have jotted down were school of self-study to process the distraction that we are getting distracted with, to counter distraction, basically, that is a must for all of us. While patience is the key, discomfort might be the mold to that, and we all need to address that. And working on the shortcomings to make them gateways, to channel them and utilize in such a way that we are actually able to achieve the goals. So these were the key takeaways that I think that we all could, actually, and we all are actually going to try that 1 minute thing in 1 hour and to count how many times we actually zone in and zone out of what we are actually doing or listening to someone. And we'll never use hearing now, but instead listening whenever we are talking to someone. So thank you so much, ma'am. It was such an amazing session and we all had an amazing, amazing evening. Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you. Thank you for listening. Thank you for being there. Great support.
Thank you all the participants who are there.
Sign off? Can we all sign off now?
Yes, yes. Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Have a good evening, everybody. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Now we are ending our meeting.